which is termed as waviness. If you consider the small portion of this wavy surface and enlarge it, it will have a surface like this, which is termed as roughness. That means profile, it consists of all the elements like the form mirror of the workpiece, and then the wavy surfaces, and then roughness of the surface. Its total contour of the surface is known as the profile, and then the roughness is the closely spaced irregular deviations on a smaller portion of waviness as considered here. And then we have the waviness, it is a recurrent deviation from a flat surface. It is like a wave on a surface of water. It is measured and described in terms of space between adjacent crests and peaks and valleys, like this. Okay, it looks something like this. This is a peak, and then this is the valley. And we measure the distance between peaks and valleys, and distance between two peaks, and such parameters we study. This waviness is caused due to deflection of tools and workpieces. For example, we have the workpiece mounted between two centers, and when we use the cutting tool, when we press, so if it is slender, it may bend like this. The workpiece may bend like this. Because of this, waviness may occur. And also, the cutting forces will cause the waviness, and temperature variations cause the variations. And if the lubrication is not proper, then also the waviness may occur, and machine tool vibration, chatter of the cutting tool. These are some of the reasons why the waviness occurs on the surface. And then maybe there are some flaws, like maybe a blowhole on the surface. On the component surface, maybe there is a blowhole, or some scratch may be there, or a crack, or some depression. So such things are known as flaws. And lay, it is the direction of the predominant surface pattern, which is visible to the naked eye. So this appears on the surface because of the tool movement of the surface. It is like a tool mark on the machined component. Now we can see all those terminologies in this diagram. So you can see this is the total profile, which consists of waviness of the surface, and then micro irregularities, micro asperities, valleys and peaks, as also the taper and drum shape or barrel shape. So that total various parameters are combined in this particular shape, and which is termed as profile. And here you can see there is a scratch in the, or depression in the surface. So this is known as flaw. And we can also see the direction of tool mark, which is termed as lay. Now when we remove this micro irregularities or roughness, then we will get the waviness like this. And this is the waviness height, that is the distance between peak and valley, and also the distance between two peaks or distance between two valleys is termed as waviness spacing. And if we remove the waviness part of the profile, then we will get only the micro irregularities, which is termed as roughness. And the distance between peak and valley is termed as roughness height, and the pitch, this pitch, that is distance between two peaks, is termed as roughness spacing. Now we'll have another diagram. We have another diagram here which will help us to understand the various terminologies. So this is a flat surface, and when we closely observe, we can see the unevenness. Okay, this is the wavy waviness we can observe, and then the direction of tool marks we can observe, and the flaw also we can observe. And then when we measure the surface finish, we will move the instrument. For example, if you take a stylus type instrument, we move the stylus or the probe on the surface to a particular length, which is termed as traversing length. And this portion, traversing length, the profile is enlarged here. You can see the waviness and the waviness height and waviness spacing. And again, if you consider the small portion of the waviness, then it is, when we enlarge it, we can see the micro irregularities. We can see the peaks and valleys, and the distance between two peaks of roughness is known as roughness spacing. And we consider a particular length of the wavy profile, and then we go for studying or the measuring the roughness. So this particular length is known as roughness sampling length. Also, it is known as cutoff length.
So here, if you observe from the specimen surface, we are going to consider a precise length over here, or transversing length here means, within that, whatever the irregularities are there, that we are going to call it as a waviness. Again, within the waviness, if you take a sampling length over here, roughness sampling length or cutoff, from that, whatever the irregularities, from this roughness sampling length, whatever the irregularities we are observing, that will be considered as a roughness, right? So like this, from the entire length of the specimen, we are arriving to a roughness, which is called as a traversing length or a spaceless sampling length. Within this waviness, if you take small sampling length, then that will be called as a roughness. Like this, from the main specimen, we are going to get the waviness, and from the waviness, we are going to arrive at the roughness.
And when the mechanical engineer specifies the roughness, we actually desire, he specifies to have a desired profile like this, which is almost flat and straight. But when we actually cut the workpiece using a machine tool and cutting tool, we get the profile like this. When we measure it, we get the profile like this. These variations are due to many reasons, like the vibration of the machine tool and the shape of the cutting tool, and then the use of various parameters, machining parameters like speed and feed, etc., etc. And then here you can see the surface is tapered. Surface is tapered like this. Okay, this is the surface profile, and so this is actually the combination of these three. The error of the form error, which is the taper in this case, and then we have waviness, and then we have roughness. All these put together, we get the profile like this. And now if we take the machining operation, very simple, very well known machining operation, that is turning operation. Now you can see this is the workpiece, and then we have the cutting tool with some round nose. This is the nose radius, and then the cutting tool is fed in this particular direction. This is the feeding direction, and then because of this radius, the tool mark appears on the machine surface like this. Okay, we get the shape. Concave shapes like this. So this gap, that is distance between peak and valley, is known as the surface roughness. This is actually the radial depth of cut, and then this is the feed rate per revolution. So when we vary the feed rate, then the roughness will change. So if you have a very fine feed, then we get the surface roughness like this. So, and if the nose radius is more, and then we get the surface roughness like this. So the geometry and the machining conditions do affect the roughness of the workpiece. So in this diagram, you can see a turned component. We have a turned component here. You can see on the face, this is the faced portion. You can see the concentric circles, and then on the periphery also we see the tool marks. And this is another surface which is face turned. You can see the concentric circles and then burr at the center, and then various the flaws, burrs on the surface. So when we vary the feed rate, this roughness will also vary. Now surface roughness in machining best possible. And then another one is the quality of the mating parts plays an important role in the performance and wear of the mating part. That is, if two surfaces are very rough, then the frictional force will be more, and the more wear will take place. And if the surfaces are very smooth, and if we can use some lubricant, then the movement will be very smooth, and friction will be less, and wear rate will also be less. The height, shape and arrangement and direction of these surface irregularities on the workpiece depend on a number of factors such as machining variables, which include what is the cutting speed. We use higher the cutting speed and finer the feed rate, we get a better surface.
So here these terms whichever are shown, which are going to affect the surface finish. Okay, if cutting speed is varying, feed rate is varying, depth of cut is more and less at the moment, we are going to get the surface finish in a different way. So it will lead to the surface roughness and waviness. So we can consider all these as the factors which are affecting the surface finish. Right, so like this, if you go on, check the things, it will be almost all same kind of information we have gone through, right? And this is a symbolic representation of the surface roughness values and the procedure how we are going to make it, right? So here, suppose a value is given like this in the slide over here. Here this particular value above this inclined lines, 60 degree inclined lines, whatever the values are there, it is going to give us the maximum and minimum roughness values. And here the symbol perpendicular is going to give us the lay direction. Then we are having a sampling length, width cutoff, okay, roughness width cutoff length, and above it we are having a waviness width, waviness length, right? So these all are we discussed over there, right? And specific terms, okay, so this part also we have there. Surface texture symbols, parallel, perpendicular, cross one, multi-directional one, circular one, then radial one, so all these things we cover. And, like this here, if you go on, search it, it is going to be said that all the values whichever are there, it is going to be done by means of surface roughness measuring techniques. So by that we are going to see all these particular informations over here. And in the process of finding the mathematical analysis manner roughness values, we are going with some of the roughness parameters like a mean line profile, roughness parameters, sampling length, all these things. So that's how we need to say that here, whatever the things are discussed over here, similarly we have covered our points over there within our discussion part, right? Okay, so with this, I want to conclude the class here itself. In the next class, we are going to discuss about the new topic, that is air measurement. Okay, so the third unit part after this roughness measurement, that is the measurement of surface finish, we are having the fourth unit as screw thread metrology. Okay, so in the screw thread metrology, we need to consider our component as a screw thread, like a screw, and on that, whatever the terms are there and whatever the parameters are there, how to find out those things. So that is our discussion point for the next class. Okay, so these are the things which are there for us in the measurement of surface finish, right? Yes, Ashwant, any doubt over here? Ashwant, are you there?
Sir, the reference you have told about this instrument, what are you use, stylus, 10 experiment you have you told.
Yeah.
And one more thing, now you have showed that something, no sir, video.
Tally, sir.
I understood come only, sir.
So I will do one thing. I will share that video to you. So once again, you please go through that.
Okay, sir.
Right. So hope you understood the knowledge of the measurement of surface finish, how it is going to be done, and what way we are going to show the symbols on the design part. So all that stuff we will come across. So by that we got a little bit idea about measurement of surface finish. Okay, so all of you please once again go through this particular topic. Okay, if at all any doubts are there, just approach me. Okay, now I'm going to start the meeting here itself. All of you go for the next class, which is scheduled by you.